no doubt this was going to be a final possession. Just watching them in our game that we played at Illinois, I mean, we were hitting on all cylinders. Sometimes we were making guarding shots, and they were missing easy shots. And so we knew that game could go either way, and this is the way it is. I mean, we just sort of resign ourselves to it and make sure that our kids understand this time of the year anything can happen, and just do your best.
How impressed were you with Nick's vision on that final play?
That was big for him to do it. I would have been fine either way, but I was just happy we could get him a little bit of freedom so that he could get a good look, and he made the right play.
How can this game and this win what does it do to tune you up for tournament time?
I think anytime you get more opportunities to play at this level and with this type of stakes on the line, you just get better. Winning and losing, you just get better. And so I'm sure if that ball doesn't bounce our way at the end, we would have gotten better from it. Now we got to turn around and get better against Ohio or Nebraska tomorrow.
Do you think the team was surprised a little bit when they opened the lead up to 13 points and all of a sudden it was a last possession game?
No. The runs are going to come in this game, and we're certainly ready for that any time. The runs are going to happen. You just got to quell the run, and we had to make good, big shots. We couldn't. And then we made just enough down the stretch to, Derek's three was a huge one for us. We got some tap backs and some rebounds that were flat out just winning plays.
John, was this something Illinois did different that allowed them so much success in the game?
No, everybody's been doing the same thing just lately. They've just taken advantage of the rules, and they had this thing, just drive it right at you. Just drive it right at you. And our big men are there trying to take charges, and they get in foul trouble doing that. And we got to do a better job of guarding our yards. So it's stuff we work on like crazy. We didn't do very well with it today.
John, do you think this game kind of gave these guys a taste of what's to come in terms of the upset-minded team putting everything out there, looking to kind of knock them off?
Yeah, I think we've gone through that all year long, that as we rose within the Big Ten, that people are coming after you, and you have to respond. The difference is you don't have your home crowd yelling at you, and that you really got to settle down and just we have just kind of, it's been a theme all year. This is a really young team, and right now we're giving up way too many easy baskets, and we just got to keep working on it.
Are you more dangerous because you've had different people win these close games for you every time?
I was asked that question before. It's a good question, because I think the number one, we've been in this situation. I think that's the fourth game maybe that we've had that we actually won. Whether if I'm going Minnesota, Purdue, what was the one that
Florida
was,
State?
Nebraska. That we won like that. So you could have gone 0-6 during some of those. I think the Charlotte game and the Arizona game breaks didn't go our way at the end, but we deserve it. And our coaching staff's coached a lot of games. Believe me, we've lost games like that, nothing different.
So these guys are Nick split that 1-1. That you usually
can
come
to the game. Yeah, this is, like I said, like Mark said, I think this is all good that we can be in these situations and experience a little bit. Yeah, we didn't care as much to 1-1 too. You got 280% foul shooters that went to the line and went 1-for-3 during that time. So that would change the game, obviously, but it's just part of this time of the year and part of basketball, part of coaching young people, whether they're seniors or they're freshmen. They're going to have ups and downs.
Two questions, guys.
Among the groups you've coached, where do these guys kind of rank in terms of executing out of timeouts when you draw one play for, one possession and that's it?
Yeah, tough question, because today we had to operate whether it was man or zone. What are they going to be in? So we thought that play would work against either one. No, they're pretty good. I would say they're up there, and I think it shows in the way we won some of those tight games.
Last question.
Are you going to watch Nebraska, Ohio State?
I'm going to go out there right now. I always like to watch even 10 minutes and get a feel for the energy, the physicality. I need to see it. So some things you see live, you don't see on video.